15.5c, radicals of mixed index. Dividing mixed index. Division with a mixed index. To do so, you must get a common index. This is like the least common multiple or least common denominator. As an additional hint, you must factor any numbers that appear under a radical. And you may have to rationalize the denominator. This is because a radical cannot be in the denominator. So, it cannot be under a radical and under a fraction. Meaning, the radical cannot be in the denominator. Let's look at how this applies in example one. Here's example one. We first must start by looking at the index. As you can see, there's no index written in the numerator. This is because if no index is written, it is implied that it is a 2 or a square root. Now we must find the least common multiple of these two indexes. This would be a 6. This means that the numerator needs to be multiplied by a 3 and the denominator needs to be multiplied by a 2. Remember, any numbers or letters that are under the radical that do not have an exponent, it is implied that they have an exponent of 1. Sometimes it is helpful to write this in as a reminder. Now, when we multiply the 3 by the index and all of the exponents, we get the 6th root of a to the 3rd, b to the 9th in the numerator. In the denominator, we get the 6th root of a to the 2nd, b to the 4th. Now that we have the same index in both the numerator and the denominator, we can combine it into one large index of a to the 3rd, b to the 9th over a squared, b to the 4th. In doing so, we can now reduce the fraction that is appearing inside the radical. We have a to the 3rd over a squared. There are more a's in the numerator, and there are more by 1. We now do the same with the b's, where there are more b's in the numerator by 5. The denominator is completely gone, and now we have the 6th root of a to the 1st, or just a, b to the 5th. As you can see, there is no radical in the denominator, therefore we do not have to rationalize the denominator, and also, none of the exponents inside are large enough to bring out of the radical, meaning we would have to have 6 or more of one of these to have them come out. Let's look at how this applies in example 2. Here's example 2. As you can see, our two indexes are 4 and 6. We must find their least common multiple. But remember the hint at the beginning was that first we must factor any numbers that appear inside of a radical, meaning the 32 or the 2. 2 does not factor it at all, so we simply have 2x to the 3rd, y to the 2nd still. And in the denominator, we have the 6th root, and 32 becomes 2 to the 5th, and the y to the 4th stays. Now that we have started by factoring any of the numbers that appear underneath the radical, we can now get a common radical. We look at the two indexes, which is 4 and 6. The common index would be 12, meaning we'd multiply the top by a 3 and the bottom by a 2. Remember, anything without an exponent, such as this 2, has an exponent of 1. We now multiply the index and all exponents by the 3, giving us the 12th root of 2 to the 3rd, x to the 9th, y to the 6th. And this is over the 12th root of 2 to the 10th, y to the 8th. Now that the indexes are the same, we can combine them into one large radical. Now that they are inside one large radical, we can now reduce. We have 2 to the 3rd over 2 to the 10th, which reducing gives us 2 to the 7th. We only have x's in the numerator, therefore they will not reduce at all. The y's reduce and give us y to the 2nd in the denominator. Now, since there is still a denominator in this problem, we must split them back apart, which gives us the 12th root of x to the 9th over the 12th root of 2 to the 7th y to the 2nd. The reason we are splitting them back apart is because we are going to have to rationalize the denominator. Because you cannot have a denominator inside of a radical or a radical in the denominator. To rationalize, remember you are looking to multiply by whatever is missing to make everything come out of the radical, meaning there is 2 to the 7th inside, which means we need 5 more 2's to get 12 2's. For the y's, we are going to need 10 more y's to make 12 y's total. Then we multiply the numerator by the exact same thing. So our new numerator is the 12th root of 2 to the 5th, x to the 9th, y to the 10th. And our denominator is the 12th root of 2 to the 12th, y to the 12th. As you can see, the denominator simplifies further. We can bring a 2 out and a y out, giving us 2y in the denominator. In the numerator, there's not enough of the 2s, the x's, or the 10s to be able to come out, which means we have 32x to the 9th, y to the 10th. Remember, you must change your 2 to the 5th back to its number, 32, for it to be the final answer. Remember, when dividing with mixed indexes, you must get a common index. As an additional hint, you need to factor any numbers that appear underneath a radical. Also, remember to rationalize the denominator if there is either a denominator inside of a radical or a radical in the denominator.